Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashok Kumar from Government Women Engineering College. This is lecture 3 of linear wire antenna series, and in this lecture 3 we are going to discuss about the finite length dipole antenna, or we can say half wavelength dipole antenna. If we are considering the length L equal to lambda by 2, in that case we are saying it's a half wavelength. Otherwise, if we are taking length L, then it is a finite length dipole antenna. The following contents will be addressed during this lecture. Initially, the background or introduction, then calculation of radiated field by a half wavelength dipole antenna, calculation of radiation resistance and directivity of the half wavelength dipole antenna, and problem based on half wavelength dipole antenna. And during this analysis, we have also calculated the radiated field by a finite length dipole antenna. The following book are considered to prepare the contents of this lecture. Introduction: the current distribution on a thin having the radius a less than lambda wire depends on its length, as we have discussed. The current distribution on a thin wire dipole depends on the length. For a very short dipole, as we have considered in lecture 2 of this series, equal to 0.1 lambda, we can say lambda by 10, it is appropriate to assume that the current distribution is triangle, as you can see in figure 5a, when L less than lambda, and when we have considering L equal to 0.1 lambda, in that case the current distribution is along the current distribution is like a triangular distribution, as this analysis we have discussed in lecture 2 of this series. As the length of the dipole increases, as we have increased the length of the dipole a significant fraction of the wavelength, it should found that the current distribution is closer to sinusoidal distribution than a triangular distribution. As you can see in figure 5b, for L is equal to lambda by 2, it is a sinusoidal, and between L lambda by 2 lambda, we are getting some sinusoidal type response. And in this figure also, first we have to analyze the radiated field by the finite length dipole, then further we have calculated the radiated field for L equal to lambda by 2, and in the last we have discussed about the calculation of radiation resistance, or we can say input resistance, when the for the category C and D and so on, as you can see in figure 5. So one by one we have calculated the radiation resistance for these different types of configurations. Further, we have calculated the radiated field by a half wavelength dipole antenna, and here you can see this is the geometry of a half wavelength, or we can say it's a finite length because we are not considering L equal to lambda by 2 here, so we can say it's a finite length. And the geometry is placed along the z axis, and it is center fed and having the total length L. And the similar analysis we have discussed in the previous two lecture of this series, lecture 1 and lecture 2. This is the origin and this is the observation point. This is the angle theta for R, then it is the distance from the origin to the observation point. And it is also assumed that for a very thin dipole, ideally zero diameter, the current on the end points, I mean minus L by 2 and plus L by 2, we have assumed equal to 0, as you can see in this figure also, L equal to lambda by 2. Here we have assumed the current is 0, as this is the current distribution and maximum at the center of this field. Then we have calculated the current for the electric conductor I of E, x dash 0, y dash 0 and z dash equal to this expression. And here you can see this is the sinusoidal current distribution as observed from the figure 5b for the length L equal to lambda by 2, or we can say 5c and 5d. So different length we have calculated the current distribution in the form of sinusoidal function, where I naught is the constant and it is the amplitude current distribution, and k is the constant equal to the free space propagation constant. Since the current has only z component, a has only the az component, using equation 2, this is the generalized equation for calculating the magnetic potential function a. And here you can see from this current distribution that it has only the az component. While considering the phase component r is equal to r minus z dash cos theta from the equation 28 and amplitude component r nearly by equal to r from the equation 32b, and this we have analyzed in lecture 2 of this antenna series, wire antenna series, for calculating the far field for the small dipole antenna. In that case we have calculated the phase component as well as amplitude component. So by considering these values, and we can calculate the vector potential function a of z is equal to by this expression. Here you can see, by putting the value of equation 53 here, and then we can integrate along the minus l by 2, l by 2, then we can calculate, and this is the az, and putting this value and integrating, then we have calculated the vector potential expression, which is equal to by this expression. And here you can see it is dependent mainly on the cos function, cos kl by 2 cos theta minus cos kl by 2 upon k sine square theta. So this is the important expression, and through this expression the similar procedure we have adopted as discussed in the lecture 1 and lecture 2 of this series, in the case of infinitesimal dipole as well as in the case of small dipole. Then we have calculated the value of AR, A theta and A phi component by using coordinate transformation from rectangular to the spherical, and we have calculated AR is equal to AZ cos theta, A theta is equal to minus AZ sin theta. In the far field region, when KR greater than 1 of the Z directed dipole, the component of the magnetic vector potential transverse to the direction of the propagation is A theta, and it is given AT. AT stands for the transverse, as we have discussed in previous two lectures also. It's a transverse electromagnetic waves is generated by the dipole antennas. So AT is equal to A theta, A unit vector into A theta. So we can calculate the electric field intensity, E is equal to minus j omega AT from the equation 41a in the lecture 2. And by putting AT from 58 and neta is equal to omega mu upon k, then we can get E is equal to this expression. And this is the very, very important expression for the 4a finite length dipole electric field equation. It is not the equation of the half wavelength dipole. So we can say it is a finite wavelength dipole equation. And further, we can calculate the magnetic field intensity, and by using equation 41b, H is equal to this expression, and we can find out the magnetic field equation for a finite length dipole having the length L by using this expression 60. Then further, we have to calculate the average power density and radiation intensity, similar to the previous two lectures. Since for a dipole oriented along the z direction, only E theta and H phi component exist in the far field region having kr greater than 1. By considering these two equations 59 and 60, the average power density W average is given. W average, this is the similar approach we have considered, and we have calculated the value of W average by using this expression 61, and putting the value of E theta upon H phi is equal to neta, and H phi is equal to E theta upon neta. Then in equation 61, then we can find out W average equal to AR 1 upon twice of neta E of theta square. So by considering the magnitude of E theta from this equation 59, the average power density at a distance r can be calculated by using this expression, and this is the again average power density equation, and represented by the expression of in equation 63. Further, the radiation intensity is calculated by using equation 62 and 63. U of theta is equal to r square 1 upon twice of theta e of theta ka square. So by considering the average W average value from this, and we are putting r square into W average in this equation, then we can find out the radiation intensity, and this is represented by the equation 64. And this radiated field electric or magnetic field, radiation intensity, average power density, we have calculated for the finite length dipole. This is very, very important to understand here. Further, we have plotted the normalized to 0 dB elevation power patterns as given by equation 64. This is equation 64. For a length L equal to lambda by 4, lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 4 and lambda. And you can see in figure 7, and this is the figure 7, here you can see, and here one important thing you can observe from this figure is that at L equal to lambda by 50, it is having the large directional bidirectional pattern and having the beam width very large in the case of infinitesimal dipole. When we have considered lambda by 4, in that case this is the lambda by 4, the beam width is slightly reduced, about 3 dB. When L equal to lambda by 2, the beam width is again reduced about 11 degree, and you can see, and this is the 9 degree, and here you can see. And further, when we have to increase, the beam width is reduces and the pattern become directional, bidirectional, and the beam width is reduced. So we can say, as the length of the antenna increases, the beam becomes narrower, beam width is reduced, because that the directivity should also increase with length. So we have found the 3 dB bandwidth for different length as we have considered here, and this is represented in equation 65, and this is the pattern. Further, we have to increase the length L and length of the dipole, then beyond one length, L greater than lambda, the number of lobes begin to increase. As you can see, L equal to 1.25 lambda, here you can see this is the bidirectional bus, but some lobes are also created here, you can see, and this is the two dimensional. So lobes are created when the length of the dipole is increases beyond the one wavelength, greater than lambda. In that case, number of lobes increases. And this is the current distribution for different length, L equal to lambda by 4 to L equal to twice of lambda. As you can see, this is L equal to lambda by 4. You can see it's like a triangular distribution. When L equal to lambda by 2 is like a it's a sinusoidal, are having the peak maximum current I naught at the feed. Then further, L equal to lambda, the maximum current in the mid of the half L by 2 dipole, and at the center it is having the value 0, and further we can evaluate. So this is again very important for drawing the current distribution for different types of length, and you can easily understand here. Further, we have to calculate the radiation resistance and directivity. To compute the directivity of a dipole of arbitrary length whose integration of equation 64 over the entire sphere, the analytical computation of integral is reasonably complicated, and we have not discussed here the analytical computation. If you want to see, in that case you can consider the C.A. Balani's book, and this is the book. In this book you can see the detailed analysis about the analytical computation. But we have considered the electric and magnetic field intensity for a half wave dipole. So first we have taken L equal to lambda by 2, and substituting KL by 2 is equal to pi by 2 into equation 60 and equation 59. 60 equation is the magnetic field equation, and equation 59 is the electric field equation. Here you can see these are the equation 60 and this is the equation 59. Then we can find out S phi and S theta component. Using the field expansion, the average radiated power density from equation 62 and 63 reduces to W average equal to 1 by 2, and this we have to reduce, and we can find out this expression for W average. So the total radiated power is obtained by integrating the power density over the entire sphere of a radius R. So integrating equation 68 over the sphere, then P radiated equal to phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi, theta is equal to 0 to pi, W average R square sin theta d theta and d phi. And we have evaluated and we have integrated first over the interval 0 to 2 pi 4 pi variation. Then we have calculated P radiated equal to by this expression 69. And performing the integration over theta, here we can get P radiated is equal to neta pi I naught upon 2 pi ka square into 1.2179. So this is very, very important. Here we get from this integration value we are getting equal to 1.2179, and this expression you can go through the analytical solution given in the Professor Balani's book, and which is equal to 36.54 I naught square. So the radiation resistance is computed by equating the average radiated power to the power dissipated in an equivalent resistance carrying the same input current. So P radiated is equal to this equation we are putting equal to the 1 by 2 I naught square into R radiated. So we have obtained the radiation resistance for a half wave dipole, which is equal to 73.0 ohm. Sometimes we have considered it equal to nearly equal to 73 ohm. So we can say in the case of half wave dipole antenna, the resistance is fixed and which is equal to 73.08 ohm. Or we can, another thing we can say, it is a very useful half wave dipole antenna when we have connected it's a coaxial cable. In that case, the input impedance can be easily matched in the case of half wave dipole antenna. Further, the radiation intensity we have calculated u of theta comma phi is equal to r square w average, which is for the half wavelength dipole antenna. Using this expression, using equation 63 and equation 70, the directivity d equal to 4 pi u. This is the generalized expression from which we are putting the value of P radiated as well as u radiated. And then we have find out the important expression directivity, which is equal to 1.642 cos square pi by 2 cos theta upon sin square theta. So this is the very, very important in the case of half wave dipole antenna having the directivity by this expression 74. But in the previous two lectures, in the case of infinitesimal dipole and in the case of small dipole, the directivity is same and which is equal to 1.5 sine square theta. Here we are getting this expression. The maximum directivity can be occur at theta is equal to pi by 2. So by putting the theta is equal to pi by 2 in this equation 74, then we can get maximum directivity d naught we have to represent it, which is equal to 1.642. And we can also express the directivity in terms of decibel, which is equal to 10 log 10 1.642 is equal to 2.15 dB. So we can say in the case of half wave length dipole antenna, the maximum directivity is 2.15 dB. Further, we can calculate the corresponding maximum effective area, and maximum effective area lambda square upon 4 pi d naught. And by putting the value of d naught, which is equal to 1.642, then we are getting AEM is equal to 0.13 lambda square. So again, this is very important expression for calculating the maximum effective area for a half wave length dipole antenna. The imaginary part associated with the input impedance of a dipole is a function of the length L is equal to lambda by 2, and it is equal to J42.5. And if you want to see how we can calculate the J42.5, then you can go through the book C.A. Balani's book. Thus, the total input impedance at lambda by 2 is equal to Zin equal to, this is the real radiation resistance and this is the imaginary part or reactance, which is equal to, so we can say इनपुट इम्पीडेंस इक्वल टू 73.0 ओम प्लस जे 42.5, एंड दिस इज द टू डायमेंशनल एंड थ्री डायमेंशनल रेडिएशन पैटर्न फॉर ए डेमडा बाई टू डायपोल. हेयर यू कैन सी दिस इज द थ्री डायमेंशनल पैटर्न एंड दिस इज द टू डायमेंशनल पैटर्न एंड दिस इज द एग्जैक्ट, बट एज द रेडिएशन इंटेंसिटी यू वेरी साइन क्यूब थीटा, साइन 2.8 थीटा एंड साइन 2.6 थीटा. In that case, you can see the radiation pattern is almost same for L, having the length L equal to lambda by 2, but there is slightly variation in the radiation pattern. Further, we need to calculate the radiation resistance for a wire antenna whose current maximum does not occur at the input terminals, as in the initially we have discussed about the current distribution for the different lengths. In that case, we are considering the figure 5c and we have to analyze, and 5d we can also consider. We have analyzed the input resistance for a dipole, you know, whose current is not maximum at the center. So by considering this figure, I in square by 2 into Rn equal to I naught square by 2 into R of R. So I naught is the maximum. So I naught is associated with the radiation resistance and I in is associated with the input resistance. So we can calculate Rn is equal to I naught upon I in chi square into Rr. So Rn is equal to radiation resistance at input terminals. Rr is the radiation resistance of the current maxima, I naught is the current maxima, I mean current at the input terminals. So this expression. Further, for a dipole of the length L, the current at the input of the terminals I in is related to the current maximum I naught, referring to the figure 11. This is the figure 11 when we have considered that I in is equal to I naught sin KL by 2. So here you can see this is the multiplication sinusoidal function and which is equal to sin KL by 2. By putting this expression in equation 78, the ratio of I naught upon I in, then we can find out the radiation resistance of any length which is equal to R in is equal to RR upon sin square KL by 2. So again, this is very important expression for calculating the radiation resistance of any dipole whose current is not maxima at the feed points. And this is the radiation resistance, input resistance and directivity of the thin dipole with sinusoidal current distribution. In that case, Rr and Rin, you can see this is represented by the Rin and this is represented by the radiation resistance, and in this axis, secondary axis, represented by the directivity. So by considering the value of L equal to 0 to 3 lambda, in that case you can find out the radiation resistance by using this expression from this figure 12. Further, we have considered one problem based on this dipole of any length. In that case, the half beamwidth between F and BW is given. We need to calculate the length L. So As we have discussed that the radiation pattern has the maximum along theta is equal to pi by 2 and the beamwidth between first null is pi by 3, then the pattern nulls we can calculate it and it's occur at theta is equal to pi by 2 plus minus 1 by 2 into pi by 3. Here you can see which is equal to pi by 3 and 2 pi by 3. So substituting the value of pi by 3, theta one value you can consider, then in equation 59, and this is the generalized equation where we have calculated and equating it to the zero, then using this expression, and we have simplified this expression, then we are getting cos KL by 4 minus cos KL by 2 is equal to zero. So this value we can get when KL by 2 is equal to 4 by 3. So when we are putting KL 4 by 3 in this equation, then we are getting the value of E field equal to 0. So we can say the length L would be 1.33 lambda. So this is the length we have calculated for such type of problem, for if depends on the finite length dipole when we are not considering the length L equal to lambda by 2. these are the two problems that to test yourself how we can solve the problem related to the any length of the dipole, or we can say monopole L equal to lambda. Then in that case, how we can calculate the VSWR. So little bit knowledge of transmission line is also required for calculating the VSWR. And this is again important problem that is associated with the input resistance of any length of the wire, and then we can calculate the radiation resistance of the dipole. And these two problems are to test yourself. So from the conclusion of point of view, in this lecture 3 of wire antenna series, we have discussed initially about the radiation field radiated by the any length of the dipole whose current distribution is sinusoidal. Then further we have calculated their current distribution and the radiation pattern for the different length of the dipole, and calculated the beam width for different types of length. And then one important conclusion we have observed, that when the length of the antenna L is increased beyond the lambda, L greater than lambda, in that case the minor lobes is also created or exist. And further we have calculated the electric field equation, magnetic field equation, radiation intensity, radiation resistance, directivity, maximum effective area in the case of half wavelength dipole antenna. And finally, the important analysis is also calculated the input resistance for any length of the wire, and we have calculated the radiation resistance RR by using this expression, and it is the multiplication factor of sine KL by 2. As you can see, this is sine square KL by 2 using equation 18. And finally, we have discussed about the problem associated with this lecture. And thank you very much to everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the monopole antenna, which is having the length L equal to lambda by 4.